Hello. In this video, we will try to create this shape. It's like a waffle, and we will be using a modifier called bevel profile to do this. This modifier can help us create many shapes without really going into a complex modeling process. I will create a new scene now and start from scratch. I'll reset. Okay. So what we need here is two shapes. One serves as a rail and a cross section. I will go to shapes, rectangle. First, I will create the rail, which is a rectangle. It doesn't matter the width and the length, but I will make it a little bit realistic. 60 centimeter by 40 centimeter. I will also fillet the edges. I will go here, corner radius. I will use a value of 5 centimeter. I think it's enough. Okay, now, okay, I will call it rail. Now, in the left viewport, I can use also the front, it doesn't matter. Still in shapes, I will choose line and I will create the cross section. First, I will make it rough and then we will play around with it. Okay, let's say like this, doesn't matter. I'm not gonna be very precise. Call it cross section. And this is all we need. The bevel profile modifier will take this cross section, place it on the rail, and make copies and connect these copies with segments. The connection happens, of course, on the vertices. You will see. Now I choose the rail, go to modify, modifier list, bevel profile. I will click pick profile and then I will pick this profile. And that's it. I will change the display to shaded so I don't see the shadows. I will move this a little bit aside. I will press F4 to see the wireframe. As you can see, it's very simple. This cross section is placed here on the rail, and many copies are created to create this shape. Now, these cross sections here, they still have a connection with this original shape. They are its parent, its children. This is the parent of all these cross sections. And what that means, if I modify this parent, the children will reflect these changes. And you will see what I mean. I will go to sub-object level, choose vertex. I will choose this vertex and watch what will happen. I will move this vertex. And as you can see, the shape updates. let's say I want this to be rounded, not hard edge. I can right click, choose Bezier. I can play around with the handle. I can also change this to Bezier and play with its handle. I can do the same here. Now, I will choose this object and let's say I want it to be open from top. I will uncheck end. If I want it to be also open from bottom, from the bottom, I will uncheck start. Now I will press F4 again to see the shaded display without the wireframe. As you can see here on the where we have the fillet, it's not very smooth. If you can see here, this is because of the rectangle here. I will turn off bevel profile for a second. As you know, maybe a curve is made of straight lines. Now if you go to here to interpolation, you will see that the value is 6. Now if I increase it, the resolution is increased, and what I mean by resolution, there will be more straight lines, smaller, and it will give the shape a more smooth look. So I will make it, let's say, 30. Now I will turn on bevel again and check it. As you can see, it is more smooth. I can do the same with this one. As you can see here, it's not very smooth. So I will also increase. As you can see, you can look and see how it's becoming even better. Try not to exaggerate with these values. Okay, now I will open it from top. Now I want to give a thickness for this waffle. The best way to do this is to go to the parent cross section, go to spline sub-object level and choose the spline. I will go to the left viewport. And I will choose outline. As you can see, the waffle has a thickness now. Now, the edges here are rough, if I want to give some fillet to these edges, I can go to vertex sub-object level. Okay, I will choose this vertex. I will click fillet. Of course, I can choose a value here and click enter, but I can also do it with the mouse. This is what I'm going to do now. I will place the mouse over the selected vertex. When you see this shape, click and drag, and as you can see in the perspective viewport, we have a rounded edge. It is reflecting what we are doing in real time. I release the mouse button, I choose the other vertex, and I will give it another fillet. And that's it. But as you can see now, it is opened from the bottom, even though we didn't choose, we didn't uncheck the option start. And why is that? It's because I will press F4 again to see the wireframe. Now these cross sections are closed, as you can see. Now we have to talk about something a bit technical. Each edge can be shared by two polygons, not more. So this edge is shared with, is common to this polygon and this polygon. Max will not create a polygon, another polygon from here. You know, it cannot create a polygon here in the middle, because in this case this edge will be shared by more than two, so it's a wrong topology. It cannot happen. So what we can do is go back to this original shape, go to segment, click on this segment and delete it. Now as you can see, it is capped now. And well, basically that's it. Now you can use this technique to create other kind of geometry. It's a very nice tool. And I hope you liked the video. Thank you very much.